Here is a really good referencing tip to help you when you're writing your essays. Your list of references need to be in alphabetical order, and there is a button on Word that will do it all for you. First, highlight your references, then click on the Sort button and press OK. And it has changed it all in alphabetical order. Hope this helps.
Assignment hacks, part one. Here's the quickest way that you can write an assignment.
Go onto Google and search the topic you're interested in.
Now copy the information that you want.
Then go onto quillbot.com and paste the information. Click paraphrase. Quillbot will then rephrase the text so that there's no plagiarism.
Now go follow us for more student tricks and tips.
Assignment hacks, part two. If you're trying to write an assignment and the article's blocked, this is what to do.
Copy the article's DOI. Go to Google and type SCI Hub TW and post a DOI in that search bar. The full article is now available.
Follow for more student tricks and tips.
Assignment hacks, part three.
Easiest way possible for you to reference.
Go onto Google and search Google Scholar. Search your topic of interest and select which academic article you want to reference. Click on this little speech mark, choose the referencing style you use, and copy and paste the reference into your assignment.
Follow for more student tricks and tips.
Assignment hacks, part four.
Is how you can reference in your assignments with minimal effort.
Go onto Google, search Cite This For Me, then choose the referencing style that you use. Now select what type of reference you're using. You complete this form to complete your reference. Now your reference is complete. Just press copy and paste into your assignment.
Follow for more student tricks and tips.
Assignment hacks, part five. Is how you can get free textbooks.
Go to this website and in the search bar, search the book that you want. Then click download.
Now you have your free book. Follow for more student tricks and tips.
Here's an assignment hack I bet you didn't know. This is the easiest way to reference on a Google Doc.
Click on Tool, Citations, choose the referencing style, select the source type, where it's from, and fill in the following details. Then click on Cite. This will give you the in-text citation. Click on Insert a Bibliography. This will give you the reference for the end of your assignment.
Follow us for more student tricks and tips. Here are the top three student Chrome extensions that you need. Number one
is Tactic, and this will help you in online lectures as it will transcript anything that your tutor says.
Number two
is Auto Highlight. This Chrome extension highlights any important information from any article.
Number three,
the last extension is Mercury Reader. This will remove any distracting adverts on your computer whilst you're working.
Now go follow us for more student tricks and tips.
The best student Chrome extensions, part two.
Todoist is the best to-do list Chrome extension. Second is Grammarly. This will help you write better assignments. And Stay Focused will block any distracting websites.
Follow for more student tricks and tips.
I've been dancing in my room, swaying my feet, trying to get you love and a kiss on the cheek. I've been dancing in my room, swaying my feet, trying to get you love and a kiss on the cheek.
Assignment hacks, part 8, is an easy way to reference in your assignments.
Go onto Chrome and search Bib Chrome extension and add to Chrome. Once you've found a website that you want to reference, just click on the Chrome extension. Choose your referencing style. The reference and in-text citation will be made for you. Just click to copy and paste into your assignment.
Go follow us for more student tricks and tips. Assignment hacks, part 9. Here's the fastest way that you can do assignments.
Go to Google Chrome and search Spreed Chrome extension. Click on the top result and add to Chrome. Once you've found a website that you want to read, just click on the Chrome extension. Now you can speed read anything you want. If you're running out of time in your assignment, just increase its speed and the amount of words you see at one time.
Go follow for more student tricks and tips.
Here's how you can get from lowercase to uppercase on Word in seconds. Same as before, highlight the text and then press Function, Shift, then F3. Now the text should be in uppercase. Don't forget to follow us for more student tips and tricks.
Assignment hacks, part 10. You're working on an assignment and got too many tabs open. This is how to organise them.
Go onto Google Chrome and search Divider Tabs Chrome extension. Click on the top result and add to Chrome. Let's say you have loads of marketing and cooking tabs open, but they're all jumbled. To organise them, right click and press Add Tab to New Group. Then name the tab group and pick a colour. For the sake of this example, I'll use marketing and pink.
Now you can open and close your tabs as you like.
Go follow us for more student tricks and tips.
Assignment hacks, part 11. Students, have you got a presentation to do?
Then go to slidesgo.com. This site is full of free templates for you to use. You can find almost any type of presentation.
Now go follow us for more student tricks and tips.
Assignment hacks, part 12. This is how to get your presentation to stand out.
Go to visme.co and create your free account.
You can use Visme to create graphics for your presentation.
Use the free templates to help your presentation stand out.
Follow for more student tricks and tips.
Assignment hacks, part 13. Here's an easy way that you can write assignments or to get ideas for your assignments.
Go onto Chrome, search Essay Bot. In that search bar, search the topic of your essay. This website will then write paragraphs about your topic. You can choose one as the basis of your essay or choose to write your own.
The best part is
there is no plagiarism and you can rephrase their paragraph.
Follow for more student tricks and tips.
Here's a simple trick to start memorizing more information. Okay, so let's say for instance you have to memorize the fact that the stomach contains the enzyme pepsin, which breaks down protein in food. Now instead of reading it over and over again, all you need to do is convert it into a question. So for example, you could have a question asking what breaks down protein in the body, to which the answer would be the enzyme pepsin found in the stomach. Now doing this will engage your brain a lot more than just reading it, and so you'll remember the information a lot longer.
Assignment hacks, part 14. Here's how you can save time doing assignments. Now usually to copy and paste you'd press
Command C and V, but it would paste in the same font from the website. It would not the font that you're using in your assignment. Instead, press Shift, Option, Command and V. This will now paste in your font.
Now go follow us for more student tricks and tips. Best student websites. Part 1. Here's the website that can give you the answers to any questions.
It's called Brainly.com. To create your free account, just copy and paste your question into the website. Then the Brainly expert will give you the answer and an explanation.
Now go follow us for more student tricks and tips. Student websites, part 2. This is the best question and answer website for students.
It's called Quora. Create your free account and choose the topics you're interested in. Here you can ask any question and people will do their best to answer them for you. There will also be Q&As for all the topics that you selected. There are also spaces you can join where you can help each other with the topics that you've chosen.
Now go follow us for more student tricks and tips.
Here are 3 tips to help you focus while studying. Tip number 1, make sure you have a healthy sleeping pattern. This is very, very important. This is going to improve your alertness and concentration. Tip number 2, make sure you have your phone away from you. So like in your cupboard or in your bag, just somewhere away from sight. If it's next to you, you're going to feel tempted to use it. And finally, tip number 3, have a designated area where you study. So for example, if you have a desk in your room, make sure to use that as a study space. This is going to make your brain associate that desk with studying. So every time you sit down, you're instantly going to be in the zone to start studying.
Student websites. Part 4. If you're studying science, then this is for you.
Go to scienceopen.com and create your free account.
Here, you can access thousands of academic journals. Follow for more student tricks and tips.